Bridge Constructor Portal? Well, it's not a hidden sequel that you haven't really heard about, but a licensed Portal game released in late 2017 with a hidden secret of its own, but a secret here that we at Digital Foundry could not help but cover when we got wind of it most recently. And to cover this hidden technological curiosity, I'm joined by the one and only Richard Ledbetter. How you doing there, Rich?
Absolutely fantastic, Alex. And this is a bit of a, how can you describe it, a different video, because it's not really our usual beat to cover games like this. But at the same time, I was speaking to a friend of Digital Foundry, Alex Go, the other day, and he was talking about how he was exploring Game Pass on the Xbox and was playing this game, Bridge Constructor Portal. And, you know, it seems everything was perfectly fine. Played it on PC, went back to the Xbox, and performance had just tanked. And Alex's remarkable discovery, I can't believe I'm saying this, on the PC version, he'd engaged 8 times MSAA. And when he went back to the Xbox version, it had engaged 8x MSAA there. So what had happened basically is that it looks like, I don't know, possibly this is a UWP port.
Yeah, yeah.
For the Windows Store. And obviously you can interchange save game data between PC and Xbox versions there. But what Alex had discovered was that it wasn't just the save game that was being shared between Xbox and PC, it was the PC settings, which are obviously inaccessible on the Xbox side of things. But by swapping between PC and Xbox, you can basically change the graphics setting on the console version of the game, which may well be unprecedented.
Yeah.
But to begin with, so obviously when we checked this out for ourselves and found it was on the level, we got you on it straight away as our PC specialist. Possibly a rampant abuse of your skills, but regardless.
I mean, it's a great usage of my time. But the funny thing I found out when you start up the game before you even touch it on PC is it shows what those default Xbox One X settings are if you had started up on Xbox before. And funnily enough, those are medium settings with 2x MSAA. And running at 4K, at least on the Xbox One X, you looked at the S version, right? What resolution was that running at?
Yeah, that's 1080p. Unfortunately, you don't have an S, which is a situation we'll have to remedy, because this remarkably small project has ended up eating up a bit of my time as well as yours.
Oh, no.
But the point is that, yes, it's 1080p on the Xbox One S, and we chose a few arbitrary things to benchmark.
Yeah.
To see what happens when you actually change the settings. And, well, basically, the long story short is that you can go from 60 frames per second to 15 frames per second.
a wobbly 15. Kind of, if you zoom back out and forth, like I'll be showing here in this footage here, it actually goes up and down depending upon how much motion blur is on the screen, because those default medium post effect settings actually don't contain motion blur or ambient occlusion. So when you ramp them up on PC to high, it adds them in and just tanks the frame rate on top of, you know, obviously turning up MSAA to 8x, which is super absurd when you think about how the game at 4K is already running 2x MSAA. And I don't want to say it's an ultra modern looking game, because it's kind of just very default Unity looking 3D. Maybe, you know, it switches over to a two-dimensional plane. It doesn't look super intense, but at such a high resolution, it starts to make sense why the game would start dipping. And I just thought it was absolutely hilarious when I loaded up for the first time, because I didn't believe it would actually happen. And then, lo and behold, even the main menu, when you get right into the main menu, it's running at a cool 15 to 20 FPS. I don't know exactly what to say. I think it's a weird oversight that they didn't notice it in all of their testing of the game, I guess.
Well, maybe they were just sort of hiving off QA to PC and Xbox specialists, and they didn't really, flip from one to the other as we're doing here. But yeah, that title screen, I mean, there's not much going on there, but on the S,
no.
The default setting there runs bizarrely at 30 frames per second, while the rest of the game is at 60 pretty much, or at least that's the target. Max takes me down to 15 frames per second, so that's 1080p with 8x MSAA. The lowest settings go to 60 throughout, and I guess we'll talk about that in a minute. And you also came up with a preset which is basically Xbox with high post effects, and that just seems to be like the default for me, but a bit more wobbly.
Yeah, that's kind of like, I think the default in itself is a bit wobbly anyway. It runs 2x MSAA with all these medium settings. And whenever a text box pops up on screen, or when something that isn't just the 2D playing field is showed, it's always basically 30 FPS.
Right.
But then it goes to 60 in the normal gameplay. If you actually end up turning off all of the settings down to low or off, which will turn off real-time shadows and kind of make the outlines around objects look a little less crisp, you end up getting a flat 60 FPS experience the entire time. And given how honestly not complex this game is, I would actually probably prefer to play it that way. It's just so weird that a game like this runs so poorly in general, even in its, you know, simplistic, you know, with its simplistic graphics. But the post-processing setting up to high, I thought it would be cool to show that off, because, you know, turning up all the other settings, like, there's no way you need 8x MSAA on 4K, you know, on Xbox One X. But the post-processing adds in things like ambient occlusion and motion blur, which definitely changed the way the game looks. It looks a lot cleaner, and it has that cool portal aesthetic then. But even the X is not enough to push that up to 60 FPS. It's just a flat 30. Kind of disappointing.
I was going to say that we are dealing with a 6 teraflop GPU that isn't able to handle these visuals with 8x MSAA, which doesn't sound particularly impressive to me, but, you know, there
no,
we go.
Especially if you look at a game like, I mean, through the Xbox Back Compat program, you're looking at games on Xbox 360 that had like 2 or 4x MSAA running really well at near 4K resolutions, and they don't look that much more complex than this, honestly. it's just that, you know, that power of Unity in the background. DX11 Unity, I think, at this point. But yeah, just kind of a funny little thing here that we don't see all too often in games, and makes me wonder if we'll start seeing more of this come next gen, because, you know, people are, you know, going to have various different types of display, 120 hertz capable of displays, 60 hertz capable, variable refresh rate. Honestly, if this wasn't, you know, a double buffered VSync game, those higher end settings probably wouldn't lock to 30. They'd probably be, you know, in the 50s and 40s for all we know, which could look pretty good on variable refresh rate displays. And it'd be nice to see more settings like this. This one's just an oversight, obviously, but it'd be really cool to see more of this on console, I think.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, interesting stuff here. It was a bit of a bizarre discovery. I'm not sure if it would apply also to the main Bridge Constructor game. I'm sure somebody in our audience might own it and might give it a go after this if they own it from the Windows store. But, you know, literally it was just our friend Alex who was just exploring the Game Pass library and came across this, and it's kind of a cool way to discover something like this, because I don't think we would have found
it
otherwise.
No, not at all. And the one thing I was really curious about that we didn't necessarily have enough time to check was if you turn down the graphics low enough, will it actually shoot up to 120 FPS? Because it seems to just be working on the principle of double buffered VSync. Did you end up testing that at all, Rich?
I didn't. No. But maybe I'll find a bit of time at some point,
yeah,
and to see what's going on there. And to be honest, we really need to be looking at the 120 hertz mode.
Yeah,
on the Xbox consoles a little bit more closely. We've kind of hinted in Dark Souls, no, it wasn't Dark Souls, it was Sekiro, how it could help to make the poor frame pacing a little bit more bearable, and there is a reason for that, but it actually has a few other properties, this mode, which are worth exploring, so we'll do that at some point. But yeah, this has been a bit of a bizarre video to do, but kind of fun at the same time.
So the question is, at the end of the day, which version of the game would you play? Default settings, lowest settings, or highest settings, Rich?
I'd play the PC version, thank you, Alex.
Yeah, by the way, the PC version, if you turn it down to the lowest settings, at least on my rig, is running at least 500 FPS at 4K, so, you know, obviously, that's your difference between Xbox One X and an ultra high-end PC. But I think that's enough for now for this odd little curiosity and a fun kind of thing. And if you did enjoy this curious little video, well, hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. If you're already a subscriber, well, consider hitting that little bell button in the corner to be informed as soon as Digital Foundry posts a video. And if you want to talk to us about Bridge Constructor Portal, write a comment below or follow Rich and I on Twitter. And until next time, this is John and Richard.
Sorry, have you turned into John? You're Alex.
I've turned into John. Yeah, say goodbye. Auf Wiedersehen. Tschüss.